sorting and accessing the vast amounts of data they're bombarded with demands another hidden power, memory. Research at Tufts University in Massachusetts aims to discover just how good pigeon memory is. Psychologist Bob Cook's been working with one special pigeon for 8 years.
This is Linus, the master of memory, the pigeon of particulars. He knows up to 1,000 images. So this is the testing chamber that we use to study the intelligence of pigeons. Inside the chamber is a touch screen that the pigeon pecks at to let us know what he's doing.
Two food trays flank a touchscreen video display. Each picture releases food into one of the trays. Both will illuminate, but Linus must remember which tray is assigned to which picture. And he reliably does, for over 1,000 images, remembering to turn right or left depending on the picture.
They're remarkable vision machines, they're remarkable memory machines. You know, they do this all with a brain that's really not much bigger than a thumb.
Dr. Scarf has discovered that pigeons can plan at least one step ahead, as well as primates do. This pigeon has been trained to peck 3 colours in a prescribed order. Red, green, blue.
Pigeons have excellent sight and can recognize human faces. Here they come.
Did you know? Pigeons recognize human faces. Researchers found that pigeons can recognize individual people's faces and are not fooled by a change of clothes.
Over the past few years, to the traditional sounds of an English summer...
Few animals on Earth have tougher lives than the pigeons that live on our streets. Most of them are never more than a few days from starvation. Job number one is finding something to eat.
I would say that only a minority of them actually get to build a nest, get a mate, have some young, and most of them die in the nest anyways because it's just cold, it's miserable, there's not enough food to feed them and so on. And then you start again the next morning. And if it snows and suddenly it becomes minus 20, then you need even more food. So you have to plan ahead before you go to bed. You got to make sure that you filled up as much as you could on food. And if the person that would normally feed you didn't come that evening, you're in deep trouble.
Like domestic pets, pigeons rely on us for food. Pigeons must always be reading the cues from us about where and when they can expect a few scraps. This relationship between bird and human is more complex than it might look. Pigeons have learned to have lookouts, to spot and remember faces, even from a distance. They recognize people who feed them routinely long before they sit down and open a bag of breadcrumbs.
They can start to recognize people by the way they walk and their routine every day, because people tend to have routines, so they may come at lunchtime, for example, and they may feed the pigeons every lunchtime. Pigeons will wait for that individual. They can see that person coming a mile away before they even pull anything out of their bag.
Not only can pigeons recognize a friendly face, they never forget a foe.
Pigeons can actually attend to people's facial features, which is pretty weird for a little bird to be able to tell people apart.
In Toronto, Scientist Suzanne McDonald is conducting an experiment to show how pigeons can distinguish ally from enemy.
You have two people, and they're each wearing different colored coats, and they sit down, and one person is the good cop, and one person is the bad cop.
Both people feed the birds, but one of them also shoos them away.
Then you find that the birds go to the one that's feeding them and not shooing them away. Well, that's not too exciting.
To test their memory retention, the scientists leave the area altogether. Return later on and try feeding them again. But the birds remember which was which, and once more avoid the person who'd been their tormentor.
And you might say, well, they're just learning other features, like maybe the colors of the coat or some obvious difference between them.
In a third session, the experiment calls for a disguise to really test their powers of recognition.
What you do is you have the experimenters then switch coats.
After swapping coats and positions, both begin to feed them again. Amazingly, despite the changes, the pigeons only respond to Suzanne, the one they regarded from the start as safe.
Which means the only cues they could use would be their facial features, which is pretty cool because it means that the pigeons are not only just walking by us in the park, but they're actually noticing us and remembering who's good to them and who's bad to them. They are way smarter than you think they are.
As one of nature's beggars, pigeons rely on street smarts to make the most of their measly prospects. Forming a kind of network, they spread out, dividing the city into territories where each bird gets the same amount of food.